per te.
Nuovo mouse?
Mm-hmm.
If you have some experience editing videos, you know that shortcuts are sweet and super helpful if you want to keep your workflow fast. Memorizing them instead is not that sweet, especially if you're moving to new software. And sometimes even using that weird combos of three keys is not ideal. What if I tell you that you can have all your important editing tools in the palm of your hand and increase your pace? Today I want to share with you my personal experience using this mouse with DaVinci Resolve. This is the Logitech G600. It's actually a MMO gaming mouse, but it can be great also for video editing. I'm not a huge fan of wired mouses. I prefer the wireless ones. Also, this wire is long and a bit cheap, to be honest. Anyway, I get the pros of a wired mouse. It's always ready, it works straight away with most devices, you never need to charge it or use batteries to make it work. This was Dani's Valentine present, because roses are overrated, and I have to say that it has been a great experience of use so far. It's made of nice plastic, and the ergonomic feeling in my hand is awesome. Besides the classic left and right buttons and the scroll wheel, you can also find on the extreme right the G Shift button, which doubles the possible settings. The uniqueness of this device, though, is on the left side, where you can find 12 fully customizable thumb buttons. All the buttons are responsive. I like the clicking sound. Also, the thumb buttons on the left side feel great. We discovered this mouse when I was looking for some editing tips on DaVinci Resolve, since I started using it for work a few months ago. We came across the YouTube channel Creative Video Tips and saw Chadwick reviewing this particular mouse specifically for DaVinci. Although I'm skeptical about wired mouses, he managed to get me curious about this particular device. You can find his video linked up here or maybe in the description below. By the way, I'm not missing at all Premiere Pro, even if I still use it for some projects. But let's talk now about these settings and how I customized this device to be the perfect mouse for my editing needs and how you can do the same. First of all, download the G-Hub app from the Logitech website, because you will need it to customize the device. Once downloaded, launch the app and start setting up your mouse. The app automatically detects your device. You can create profiles for every app you want. These profiles will be automatically enabled every time you enter that specific app. So red means that I'm in default profile, so desktop profile, but as soon as I move into Resolve, I have the feedback from the color of the thumb buttons, and it's really great. Creating a new profile is very easy. Choose the app and start setting it. there are three main areas you can play with: DPI sensitivity, assignments, and light sync. The first and last ones are just a matter of personal taste. For example, I matched the color of my thumb buttons with my laptop keyboard. The most important part for video editing is assigning specific functionalities to each button. For that, you want to use macros, which are sequences of combination of keys. It's very easy. Choose the combination you want, give a name to the macro, record it and save it. Then you can assign it to a specific button. It's easier remembering just one button than a combo of keys, isn't it? If you run out of buttons, don't you worry, because you have the power of the G Shift button. Clicking it or activating it on the G Hub app allows you to have a second layer of assignments. One of the most common things for a video editor is to split a clip. The command split is my first thumb button. So if I click G9 now, for color grading, being able to save and load color memories fast, it's really crucial. So I created macros for them and assigned them to specific buttons. I decided to put these operations in the second layers of button that we are able to activate thanks to the G Shift button. I made this visible and beautiful color correction. If I want to save this image, this color correction, I just keep pressed the G Shift button plus the G13 thumb button. Now the color correction is saved and I can easily apply this correction keeping pressed G Shift button plus G14 thumb button. If you don't know where to start, Logitech provides you with a whole library of profiles. You can take some inspiration from there or even choose one, download it and customize it as you please, as I did using the Creative Video Tips profile. I will try to figure out how to upload and share my profile too. Maybe it can be helpful for some of you. To conclude this video, and to be honest too, I have to say that I don't 100% like the G Hub app. It's not the most intuitive to use, and it took me a while to get used to it. I even created a new profile for DaVinci while customizing the Video Creative Tips one. I still don't know how I did it. Besides, I can't even delete it now, which really annoys me. Anyway, it's cool to be able to fit your device to your needs. This mouse made my switch from Premiere Pro to DaVinci Resolve less painful. I enjoy using it, and so I will keep on doing it, even if it has a while. Last but not least, you can have a powerful tool in your hand for a reasonable price. If you are switching, or if you are considering to switch to DaVinci Resolve as your main video editing software, make sure to check Creative Video Tips YouTube channel, because it's full of helpful topics. That's all. See you in the next video. Bye!